You know, you can only beat a dead horse for so long. And then there are times when that dead horse is a zombie and comes back to life, or tries to come back to life, and you can beat it over and over again because it's just funny. You know, you can delete all the videos that you want. You can scrub your entire life from the internet. And there are people who are going to remember what you did. And I'm one of those people who remember exactly what you did. This video is a two-parter. A two-parter in a sense that I'm going to be talking about his new About Me section, which is what I have up on the screen right now. And there's a 28-minute video that I am going to also be talking about after I finish this. Onision is, he's the only person in the world that I know who talks the way that he talks. Nobody talks the way he does. I want to put this out there. He makes up terms and words. He's trying to put three or four different X's in one person here. At least that's what I'm trying to get out of this. let me get through this. Let me get through this first sentence here. All right. Onision was framed and socially executed by a fraudulent smear campaign. Oh, nothing about what happened to him was fraudulent. Everything that was about him, he did himself and has video evidence of doing so. Go through my channel and find all the videos that he has done. Everything that he's done has been on my channel, including the Chris Hansen interviews. Okay. I need a cigarette right now. Give me a second. Onision was framed and socially executed. First of all, nobody uses the term socially executed. That doesn't make any sense. It only makes sense in Greggy Boy's mind. Okay. Greggy Boy is a special case. He's really special. He is the epitome of a psychopath and somebody with delusions of grandeur. He is super delusional that he actually believes himself to be this emo Jesus. I kid you not. I mean, I guess it kind of doesn't help that he did grow up in a really religious household. But then again, I do not blame his parents, because his parents actually fucking tried to be parents to him. He just refused to be an actual decent human being. It's just incredible. He's like the exception to the rule here. It's absolutely just stunning. Now the second sentence here. Onision's life was destroyed by someone he rejected, removed from his life, due to them being a danger to him, his family. First of all, stop with the weird pronoun usage here. Nobody talks like this. It's even weirder reading it. Okay? Rejected, removed. He loves the word rejected. He uses it quite a lot here. It's ridiculous. It is so bad. I don't understand why he loves to use the word rejected here. He's like a permanent teenager, and is like, he's mentally stunted. I rejected. It's rejection. This rejection. They're mad because I rejected them. No, Greg, you didn't reject them. You forced yourself onto Sarah the day after she turned 18, when you and your wife were having a moment in bed, and your wife left, and then you decided to force yourself on her. We saw the video that she had an interview about, Greg. You are a fucking idiot. And her being a danger, she's like 50 pounds soaking wet, dude. How is she a danger? But he continues on. The person Onision removed confessed to doing extremely illegal drugs, dealing drugs illegally, violating him and another person and others' behavior that made it clear Onision could not continue to have them in his life without them endangering him and his loved ones. Jesus Christ, that sentence is terrible. Well, let's break it down. The person Onision removed confessed to doing extremely illegal drugs. First of all, you're trying to put three or four of your exes, and when I said that, this is what happened to Billy, right? This is Billy. Apparently, the extremely illegal drug that she had confessed to smoking weed, and he tried to get Billy to tattoo "I'm a liar" on her forehead. I mean, does that sound like a person who's being socially executed and framed? No. No, that sounds like a fucking psychopath. Doing extremely illegal drugs. Boy, you think marijuana is fucking extremely illegal? No, the fuck it ain't. This ain't the 90s anymore, brother. Come on. I threw up in my mouth saying that about Greg. Violating him and another person and others' behavior. I don't understand that sentence, really, that part of it. It's somehow, I guess, how Greg thinks he's violating him, another person, his spouse, I guess, and made it clear could not continue to have them in his life without her, endangering his loved ones. He's trying to put like two or three of his exes in the same fucking sentence. That makes no fucking sense, Greg. God, even your About Me section, I haven't even got to the video yet, and we're already in this fucking mess. Okay, the next sentence says, the same individual had blackmailed Onision into being with him, when Onision couldn't take being blackmailed any longer, he rejected them, her. There he is with the rejection word again. As a result, they quickly followed through with their initial extortion or threat to destroy him. Greg, oh my God, Jesus fucking Christ. Exposing you for what you did to her? If there was nothing you did wrong, there would be no extortion or threat to destroy you because you forced yourself onto her, then forced her to sign a non-legally binding NDA. You did that to Sarah, man. The fuck is wrong with you? And then not only did you force yourself onto Sarah, you drove, you were going to fly, then the flight was canceled. Then you drove to Pennsylvania from Washington to basically statutory rape a 17-year-old girl because it's legal in Pennsylvania. I bet you're the type of guy to know all the legal ages of consent in every fucking state. Because that's the only way you would have been able to do that. There was no extortion, Greg. You fucking did this to yourself. You forced her to sign a fucking NDA. And because she broke the terms of that, that's not extortion, Greg. She's using her intelligence over yours. You believe that you're some kind of like three. Sorry. You believe that you are some kind of like 300 fucking IQ bullshit. You're not. Because nobody talks the way you do. Jesus Christ, man. Onision lost his job, means to support his family because of her, or the exes, I guess, and was fraudulently labeled a monster to millions. You were not fraudulently labeled a monster to millions. You did this on your own. There was nothing that you could have done to change that. These were your own actions, Greg. You did this. This was nothing fraudulent. It's all exposed. It's all there. You did this, man. You were removed from Patreon because Patreon recognized what you were doing was wrong. And then you started to use your spouse's Patreon as a backup plan because that's not sketchy at all. Like, holy fuck, my dude. You are ridiculously stupid. The police report confessing Onision did nothing. That's one police report, Greg. That's not all of them. You are trying to confuse one police report that was out and using that as the whole thing. You're like Russia. You try to attack places that nobody protects and claim that as victories. Jesus fucking Christ, man. Their now deleted interviews vindicating him, texts and other evidence clearing Onision was ignored and buried.
No.
Oh, God. The interviews, I need to actually double check that and fact check that the interviews are now deleted because I still have the interviews up on my channel if you want to go see those Chris Hansen interviews. They're not vindicating. That doesn't mean vindicating, dude. Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. That is just a mess. And that About Me section was just, oh my God, dude. Like, just full of lies, as usual. Because nobody fucking talks the way you do. Oh, I gotta mentally prepare myself for the next part of this. I need a drink. I kind of wish I was drinking something a little bit harder than iced tea right now. Okay. Because nobody talks the way that he does. It's so frustratingly bad, man. That was hard even for me to get through. And I did it. I took a huge nap earlier today, and sorry if you can hear my roommate in the background. It's not what I want to hear. Okay. Media player. We're going to pull this up. Window capture. What is wrong with my video capture here? Display capture. We don't need that anymore. Okay. Remove window capture. I need to actually put the window capture back on. Cancel.
Hey.
There we go. So he did this video a year ago, around last year. It doesn't say exactly what day. But we are going to try to get through this video as much as possible. I'm probably going to pause a lot because that's how ridiculous Greg is. And I might have at least two cigarettes here watching this. Just finished the first one. All right, let's quit jerking around and let's actually watch this video. I don't want to. I downloaded this one, by the way, so it's not on his channel. I am not giving him the engagement or the farming. I'm not giving him that. I'm not giving him the satisfaction. Okay. All right, there we go. Sorry if you can hear my roommate in the background. I really am. I'm going to put some music on in the background just in case later.
Hey guys, this video, in a way, has been made before, but I don't think it's ever been made like this.
Oh, for God's sake. This is going to be really hard to get through. I think I know which one he's talking about. The goodbye video. I did the video already, the dissection video. I think I'll put a link. I'll put a link to my entire chronicle in the description box below, so you can go check out those videos. This video will also be added. Oh, let's keep going, shall we?
When you experience the online community, depends on what generation you're a part of, but...
No, first of all, no. When you experience the online community, depends on what generation you're a part of. Already, you're already full of shit. So, let's continue.
When I first started, I was U.S. Air Force Security Forces.
You weren't anything in the Air Force, Greg. You were barely out of Sears school. And then you dropped out. You dropped out because I was having suicidal thoughts because I'm a little bitch. All right.
Airman. So I was serving my country, and...
You did not serve your country. You were in basic training, and you dropped out. That's not serving your country, Greg. That's barely being a waiter. Oh my god, he's already lying. You know he's lying when his fucking mouth is moving. Jesus fuck.
You know, at first, the whole thing was a wild story. And I wrote about some of it in one of the books I put out or about to be released, I guess. I don't know.
Oh, God, Greg. Your book, it's not. Your book is fiction. It is fiction. You cannot differentiate reality from fiction. Holy fuck. Just in this one, not even a minute long, and he's already fucking lying, dude.
But I thought that YouTube was a really cool, awesome thing.
It is. It exposes predators like you.
And oh my god.
Also, why is your face so close to the fucking camera? God, you're fucking ugly.
It really was. Like, the biggest thing on YouTube was, like, memes. And I guess they just took a lot of, like, content from other people.
I guess they took a lot of content from other people. That's how the internet works, Greg. Fuck, dude.
Hey, full movie. Watch now on YouTube free. Like, you know that. But, no, YouTube used to be dope. It used to be super cool.
It was super cool because you were not the... It was a different time back then. You can't do the kind of stuff now that you used to. You have to keep evolving and changing with how YouTube works. That's why I'm Chaos Archives now. It's going to be more about me, how I think, how I reflect on things, how I'm going to be doing things in the future, whether it's a video game, whether it's something else. You got to keep changing with how things are, Greg. You cannot keep it. Jesus, man. Stop fucking lying, bro.
It was a small community. And I got featured on the main page of YouTube, and it was awesome.
You got featured on the main page of YouTube once because of your goddamn banana song that you made, and you got made fun of by Tosh.0 back in the day.
For a song that people informed me was terrible. It was
It's fucking terrible. It is awful.
I'm So Gamer.
Oh, that
you
one?
You can go listen to I'm So Gamer now if you want to hear how bad it was. But it got 770,000 views, which I thought was really cool. I like that. Views. But it got, you know, mostly dislikes, unfortunately. Or actually, no, back then it was like 5-star rating. So it was not rated well.
Yeah, take that as a fucking... That is, just because you are using views, you think views are better than the like-dislike ratio. Back then, it was star rating. You are not a high-rated person at all. You're an idiot. you're stupid, but you're not a high-rated person.
It's like a 2.5 or something. Point is,
should have been a 1.
That got me like 1,000 subscribers or something, and that was really cool. Love that. And then I like beefed with The Amazing Atheist, and it was about vegetarianism where...
You didn't beef with him. You wanted to start a fight with him. And he refused to. He refused to fight with you, which pissed you off. And now you're going to lie about it.
He said, for every video that this vegetarian makes, I want you to go out of your way to eat meat, is what he said. And so I made 8 videos back to back.
That actually sounds like something TJ would say, actually. But that was old TJ. That was a different kind of TJ. Back then, TJ was actually pretty right on a lot of subjects. And you don't like the fact that you're a vegan, he's a vegan, and you're not. Or he's not.
To make people sick of eating meat. Like, just...
That's not what he said, you fucking moron. To make people sick of eating meat. No, that's not how it fucking works, Greg. That's not how it fucking works, you fucking moron. He's doing it to spite you. To spite you. Ugh.
One after the other, I'm like, it's like smoking a full pack of cigarettes to get people over it.
No.
Yeah, that backfired a little for The Amazing.
That's not how it works. Any smoker knows this.
Atheist. But that was funny, and it was cool. It's a cool experience.
You think so. Only because you're a fucking moron and you're delusional.
And he and I eventually met. I think we shook hands. This is a much bigger man than me. Physically.
Because he's fucking tall. He's like 6'2", 6'3". He's a fucking monster, dude.
I don't know about the other stuff. You'd have to do a full biography on both of us to really figure that one.
Ugh. God. Actually, Sarah already exposed how much. We already know how fucking tiny you are. He probably has a bigger dick than you. Ugh. I don't even want to think about either one of those.
But there was so many cool people on YouTube at the time. Like, Shane Dawson was super cool.
Of course, you can't stop talking about Shane Dawson. Jesus Christ, you got to bring him up because... Ugh.
There was this guy named Keep the Heat, which I didn't really like.
I don't know who that is.
Why would I say it then? Just wasn't a huge fan, I thought... It just wasn't my brand of comedy. He did a lot of things that were like putting a celebrity in his thumbnail for a music video. And he's like, Jay-Z in this. And then you click on it and it's just him. There's no celebrity rapping or anything. It worked for him. He was doing something right or wrong.
Oh, like you think you are? Jesus fucking Christ. I'm not going to get through this fucking video. It's 28 minutes long. Jesus. And we're already 23 minutes in. This is going to be a long video.
I was more of a butts and cleavage in the thumbnail. And then I would like, you know.
What you did? Where you were rating young girls, 13 and 14, whether that Onision would date them or not. Jesus.
React to it in the video or whatever for like. Celebrities with plastic surgery or whatever.
Fucking liar, you piece of shit.
You know, like, stuff like that. But, no. In the beginning, YouTube was very cool. It was very fun to mess with the algorithm and try to figure out what's what. And we had a lot of free speech back then.
You have a lot of free speech now. You just gotta pick and choose what you can and can't say. I mean, I guess he doesn't understand how free speech works. If you're getting popular on YouTube, you need to control how you say things. And that's for advertisers. And that's how ads work. And if the advertisers like you, they're going to give you more. They're going to give you money. They're going to give you money to promote their product. if you say certain words, like there are certain ways that advertisers will allow you to do things. They will not allow certain things.
You could say a lot of things that you cannot say anymore, like iDubbbz would drop the N-word with a hard R
Nobody cares.
over and over and over again, and he was fine back then, which is not fine. It's not okay.
It wasn't okay then. It wasn't okay then. Jesus Christ.
I was in videos bleeping out the word NIDD, nid, and people thought it was NIGG. No, I bleeped it because it was nid.
You did not. You know exactly what you were doing, Greg. He knows exactly what he's doing. Oh, God. I don't know if I'm gonna get through it. I'm gonna try.
Because I was making fun of racist people, but no, people are like,
You were not making fun of racist people, Greg. Jesus Christ, holy shit. Sorry about that.
see, this is proof. And it's like, no, I was saying nid and bleeping out the duh part.
No, you weren't. No, you weren't. See, you gotta. This is how Greg lies. He'll look back and forth. He'll do this. He'll be like, this is exactly what I did. I'm broken.
So it would sound like it as a joke because I was making fun of racist people.
Oh God, you are not. Holy fuck, dude. I gotta. I might even have my fucking third cigarette watching this bullshit.
That's why I was doing it in a southern accent because only southern people. I'm just kidding.
Fuck you, you ignorant piece of shit.
The South rise again. That was like the whole song. Like,
you kombucha bitch.
people didn't get the joke. They did back then, but now they don't get the joke. That's kind of the problem.
No, it's not the problem. We understand what you were doing, Greg, you fucking piece of shit.
Right. I also made this video where I was throwing literal candy corn at my girlfriend at the time, who was dressed as Harley Quinn. She was dressed as Harley Quinn. I was dressed as the literal Joker.
We know. We saw the video.
And I was throwing candy corn at her, and as the Joker, I said, "No one will know how much I abuse you because I'm."
You think this wasn't funny? She didn't think it was funny.
Throwing candy corn at her, right? It's a joke. Yeah. Today, like back then, it got 1,000 likes and like 1,100 and something likes and like maybe 50 dislikes. Today, people are like, "Oh my God."
Because you're not supposed. Oh, God. You cannot see, this is the kind of shit that he thinks is funny. It's not funny. I saw the video myself too, and she did not think it was very funny. I actually have that video down in my. I think I might have that as well.
Oh my God. And it's like everyone got the joke back then, but people don't get the joke now. Like freaking the director of Guardians of the Galaxy, he tweeted something about liking little boys.
Oh, God, here we go. You are not going to be talking about this.
Right? It's a joke. He was joking. Gross. Super gross. But he was joking, right? People got the joke back then, and then today they're like, "What a monster!"
That's not how it works, Greg. That is not how it works. There are things that you can be funny, there are times where it can work. It's your intention. Back then, people don't understand the intention. A lot of times, people cannot differentiate between jokes online on Twitter, and they can't. a lot of people do not know what the difference between a joke is through text. Okay. If he said it as a joke, you'd have to know what his joke was about. And apparently you get it. I don't get it.
Which, by the way, now he's in charge of the whole DC franchise or something like that, because the cast of Games of Thrones, Guardians of the Galaxies,
it's Guardian of the Galaxy, you fucking moron.
Galaxy, they stood up and they said,
over 100 IQ.
But no, this was a joke. Understand a joke. And people tweet jokes all the time, like PewDiePie tweeting, everyone has their tricks to get...
Yes, everyone jokes all the time on Twitter. But there's a difference, brother. There's a difference between a joke and something that's not funny and something that is funny. Your type of comedy isn't funny. It just isn't. Yeah, we got a lot of shit to get through here.
It was horrible. Horrible joke. People got it. Shane Dawson was tweeting at someone about sticking a banana inside their body.
Okay. Who fucking gives a shit, dude?
Hannah.
Get to the fucking point. Is there a rest stop between here and the fucking point?
In an inappropriate way. People got the joke back then. They didn't get it later.
I think the point he's trying to make here is you can joke about something now, or you can joke about something then that you can't joke about now. And it's true. He is right about that part of it. But what you did, Greg, what you did to these women is not a joke. It's not funny.
Our current culture is the scariest thing ever.
I hate to be the one who agrees with him on certain things, but when a clock strikes, you know, twice and all that. A broken clock strikes right twice. Okay, and this is a living proof of that. You are correct that today's culture, you cannot say or joke about certain things. It's not scary or something. It's just how it is, unfortunately, because a lot of people are fucking pansies, and I do agree with that. But nobody thought you were funny. Nobody thought you were this great YouTuber. And I read some of the comments on this video. Jesus Christ. I know he goes through comments and deletes all the bad ones, because that's just how he is. That's how delusional he is. But let's try to continue.
Because what they try to do is they try to criminalize or otherwise seriously hurt you for jokes.
No, 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 no. That's not how it works, Greg, and you fucking know it, you fucking liar. There he is. He's lying again.
And that's really, really scary. I'm not talking about like privately telling people jokes or privately saying something to someone who's they perceive it as a joke or don't perceive it as a joke and blah, blah, blah. We're talking about public, like when people publicly say things and they're like in the genre of entertainer or in the genre of comedy or whatever. And people are like, yeah, that's real.
Okay. It is your intention. It is how you say it. If you say it as a joke, then you can. You watch. He's probably going to bring up Dave Chappelle or something like that. Probably won't. We'll see.
That's totally real. Like now.
That's not how it works. That's how your delusional little brain works.
But back then they were like, ha ha ha, we get the joke. It's like people lost their sense of humor over time. Anyway.
That, again, I will admit, he is right. People do not have the sense of humor that they used to. A lot of people think, punching up, you gotta punch up to me, it's funny. No, I don't believe in that.
Issue, and with a number of other issues, people are so quick to try and make living as a human being miserable.
Here's the thing, you did this to yourself. Nobody else did this to you.
Do you understand? Like, people online...
Do you understand? Because you are permanently online, Greggy boy.
...and are so quick to pick someone who they think is above them, that they want to pull down to their level or whatever, and just try and do everything.
Did you honestly just think that you're above everybody? What? What? Okay.
You can't destroy that person's life for the lulz. And that is the internet environment that we are currently in.
No, it is not. You don't know how it works, Greg.
We're in a community that is terrifying, deeply
Holy fuck.
horrifying. Like the amount of lives I've seen destroyed by the internet. Like Jenna Marbles was a
Here we go. Okay. Of course, he brought up Jenna Marbles. I'm going to bring up Jenna Marbles a little bit here. I liked her content, but when she started saying dear fat people and all this other nonsense and shit like that, she stopped being funny and it started showing her true colors a little bit. Nobody liked that.
good example when you guys made her cry on camera for something that was like a misunderstanding.
It wasn't a misunderstanding. She knew what the fuck she was talking about. She knew what the fuck she was doing. Like you are.
You know, like there's so many
Her life wasn't ruined. She did apologize for what she said. That's how you're supposed to do things, Greg.
people who are actually decent people that the internet just ripped apart and tried to ruin the life of.
Oh, every time he says that, I fucking roll my eyes.
And you gotta ask, like, is it really so bad flipping burgers for a living? Like,
Is it? Because you don't seem to.
is this really worth YouTube monetization or whatever? Dang
Oh, that's the best thing
it.
that happened in this fucking
I'll
video.
be back in a second. Okay. Hi again. So lately I've been able to tap into a weird kind of optimism. It's been going on for, I don't know. I don't know. But it's been going on for a little bit. Some days I'm bitter and angry, but some days I'm actually really doing relatively okay because it's
Oh, God.
like there's a story and I want to share it with you, okay?
Oh, here we go. A bunch of lies. Here we go.
There was this movie I saw. It was like a French film or something. I don't know what it was. Not my language, but I went to see it in a theater and I read the subtitles the whole time to see it. I don't know how I wound up in that theater. It was a real indie thing. Felt like a real hipster. But
Shut
when
the
I saw
fuck
this
up.
movie, it was about a man who went to a concentration camp. And he went there with his son. And his son didn't understand that they were in a death camp.
Oh my God. Is he actually going to compare himself to Jews? Is he actually going to compare himself to be? We are almost 40 minutes in here. God fucking damn
And so the
it.
father understood that the happiness of the son was like the most important thing ever, right? And so he's trying
Apparently, you
to
don't
explain
understand that.
things and their situation in a way that won't hurt the son, that the son can understand that this is kind of like, you know, something he shouldn't think about, and trying to make a fictional universe around the son so he's not psychologically damaged by what's going on.
Oh
And this father, he's such a good person. He sees like a pile of dead Jewish people who were killed by the Nazis, and he's trying to distract his son from that. And he's just generally trying to make the best of a terrible. He's trying to
Keep
make the
going.
best of a terrible situation for his son. And I can relate to that
Oh God,
in the
yes,
sense.
oh fuck, I called it. I can relate to that. Oh God. Ah, here we go. I fucking called it. I fucking called it. Let's continue. Let's see where he's cooking.
That the love a father has for a son is overwhelming, and it's really important to treasure and value the health and the mental health and everything of kids, especially your own kids.
You don't give two flying fucks about your own kids. Otherwise, you wouldn't be doing YouTube. There are YouTubers right now who quit YouTube just to be with their kids. Like you should. But you're you.
So, seeing someone, you know, even though it's not exactly a documentary, but it's like seeing someone who's a father, based on it's written by fathers. I'm sure written by people who have that the father experience or whatever. Seeing someone in a concentration camp going through something so terrible and still trying to maintain a positive attitude and stuff like that, that's one of the most beautiful aspects of human beings. And
It's something that you cannot relate to. You are not, oh God, Jesus fucking Christ.
the human experience is that you can be in the worst possible situation, have everything taken away from you, be in a death camp where they're mass executing innocent people, and
Are you gonna fake cry?
still do everything you can to keep hope alive and the human spirit alive and stuff like that.
Oh,
So,
fuck's sake.
I'm just saying that, like, if you have the opportunity to make your life better and to make the best out of things, you should, even if it's going to cost you money, even if it's going to cost you, like, significant temporary losses or whatever, or you can't live out your dreams. Like, for instance, my dreams were creative since I was 15 years old.
Then you should have taken your parents' offer and going to film school, you absolute fucking dunce. Because YouTube is not. Okay, here's the thing. I would love to be making money doing my YouTube channel. I would love to. But the way YouTube works is that you have to be a certain way. You can't do things like you would like to in order to make money in content like you used to. YouTube rules now is completely different than it was 10 years ago, 15 years ago. When you were 15 years old, Greg, you were a piece of shit. You're a piece of shit now, but still. And from what your parents said, they tried with you. And here we go again.
Well, I was making videos and doing really entertaining things in making videos for people that I thought would help them, like don't self-harm, don't kill yourself, don't.
And you acted like a douchebag the entire time. There's a difference between trying to help other people and trying to be a good person and stuff like that. There's a subtle nuance that can come with it. But with you are a piece of fucking shit with it.
This is how you deal with depression, and this is how.
You don't know how any of that fucking works. Because you're not a therapist, you are not a good person, you are just an asshole. And not the fun kind of asshole. Like there's a type of asshole that you can actually, talk to and understand and communicate with, and then there's you. Oh God, this fake ass crying shit. Actually, I don't think he's faking it right here, but we'll find out.
I made thousands of videos and dedicated over a decade of my life to creating videos for people, and I wanted them to be helpful. And yet I said so many things that I regret.
You absolutely do not. If you do regret it, then that's a plus for you. But hey, you're a giant turd. And the fact that you would rate young girls at like 14, 15 years old, whether Onision would date them or not, that's just fucked up, dude. Nobody cares. Nobody likes that.
And I did so.
And it doesn't matter what time frame you are from, like you could be on the internet back. I was on the internet back then. I knew how the internet worked. I was doing videos like that, but I wasn't doing videos like you were doing videos. Jesus.
So many things that were popular and were demanded of me, like.
Demanded of you? No, bro. Not demanded of you.
Like, oh my God, talking about, furries,
Oh, fuck.
which was, I didn't
Where did that come from?
care about furries, but every time I talked about furries, people were like, click, 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 like, monetization, all this stuff. And so I'm like, okay, let's talk more about furries. Or like, there's these people who are into something called DDLG, and they dress up as babies for their partner and stuff. And I was like, this is gross.
Oh my God, that's a completely different thing, Greg. There's a difference between DDLG and dressing up like a baby. That is not the same fucking thing, you absolute fucking dipshit.
I hate this, but people are like, every time I made a video about it, it would just explode, so I kept making videos like making fun of people who dressed as babies.
That I can completely agree with. It is disgusting, but it's not the same thing.
And it's just like, none of that was really my interest. My interest was making videos that helped people.
Then why didn't you stick with it? Why didn't you stick with it? Stop trying. Just because it blew up doesn't mean that you have to keep making videos that way. This is your delusional thinking coming through.
Or expressed my honesty and where it was used as my therapy. And then I'd make comedy videos that were really awesome. I loved making comedy videos.
Screaming doesn't mean comedy, dude. Sorry.
And just being able to joke and look in the comments and see people saying wonderful things and encouraging me, and I would make more comedy videos, and it was amazing.
Because you delete hate comments, Greg. Just admit that.
Amazing. And that was like 2009, 2010, 2011, 2012. So I had a great time.
God. I need to go get another pack of cigarettes before I...
Things have changed.
Video.
A lot. And I don't want to talk about all my problems. I don't want to talk about, like, the things people tweet.
We are still 12 minutes away from being fucking over. And you said a lot of bullshit.
Or the videos people make, or the things people say in the national television. Like, it's so crazy. I was just a guy. You know, I was just a...
This is not true. None of that is true. This is what you fucking did, you monster.
Random guy serving in the U.S. military who is making stupid, funny videos. And then
you didn't serve in the military, you fucking piece of shit. You dropped out of basic. That doesn't count.
And it blew up into me getting like 2 billion views before Adpocalypse. I got like 2 billion videos.
Okay. So I had fucked up right there. I hit the wrong thing. Adpocalypse, both of them that had happened, there was two of them, and had nothing to do with you. Okay?
Why is he mad? Because humans get mad. Why is he sad? Because humans get sad. Why does he think this is funny? Because sometimes people think things are funny. Like, everything is explainable through basic human psychology.
Which you are not a psychologist. You are not a therapist. Stop it. You're anyway, breathing heavily.
So I was loved for a long time by a lot of people. And then at some point things turned.
You were not loved, dude.
And then everybody hated me.
They hated you because of what you did. You still are delusional.
And those issues are so complicated, and
they're not really complicated if you actually go to my videos right now and go check them out. They're not that complicated, brother.
Or maybe they're simple. Don't piss people off. Like, literally.
Here's the simple thing. Don't force yourself onto people, you fucking creep.
Maybe it is simple. When you piss people off, they piss back. You know, like,
maybe if you didn't force yourself on people, you absolute fucking degenerate nutball.
If you piss on others, you're going to get pissed on. And just turns into a pissing contest, and everyone's covered in pee by the end of it. So I guess that's the summary. Don't piss people off. Especially since, like...
No, the summary is don't force yourself onto people. Wait for the consent first, you dick.
I've prided myself on being the most honest YouTuber.
You know you're full of shit when you start laughing about that. You are not the most honest YouTuber.
One of the most. I always said one of the most, because of course I couldn't possibly be the most honest because I haven't surveyed every YouTuber. But I passed polygraphs, you know, and I've had Yankee White.
Okay, the reason that you can pass polygraphs are really, really fickle. Okay. If you believe yourself, if you believe it hard enough without jumping the heart rate up, polygraphs are only... That's why they're not used in court anymore, Greg. Because people can just outright lie. And you believe your lies so much that you can pass a polygraph test. That's how it works.
Security. I'm pretty sure I've had Yankee White or just under Yankee White security clearance. So the U.S. government trusted me with like... It was like a big deal. I was certified in like every way as far...
You are certifiable.
As far as my honesty went. So yeah, I have good reason to say that. Discharged under honorable conditions. Originally discharged.
No, you were discharged with other than honorable, you absolute dumbass.
Charged honorably, but I think because I served 3.5 years and not 4 years, it had to be downgraded to under honorable conditions. But the point is...
No. You did not serve for 4 years. You didn't even pass basic, you absolute lying twat.
You know, I do...
And then you did a video, and then you did a song in your uniform talking about how much you hated the military. That, Greg, it doesn't matter how long you spent in the military, and this is coming from somebody who has military in the family, that you can serve as long as you want, and if you do things the right way, there will be no demotion of how you were dishonored. You were dishonorable.
I really do value that blunt honesty. And blunt honesty, the problem with it is these days, it's not compatible with the world. And it upsets people. And it makes my life harder for my family.
You absolute fucking dipshit. I have a video that I have to get through. I may actually finish this up later. I will be back later. See you guys. I thought I would have enough time, but I guess I overslept by a deal. But I will finish this part out. God, I still have like 8 fucking minutes to get through this. I will finish this part out. I will leave a link in the description below. And if you guys want to, give me a follow and leave a comment in the comment section below which part you thought of this video was the funniest. I thought it was the part when his camera fucked up. But I will see you guys later. Peace.